Okay, so now that you know that a certain charge will be stored when the potential difference is meets, now let's understand what will happen when you place an insulator material in between the two plates. Will the capacitance become more or less? Will the amount of charge which will end up getting stored become more or less? So there are two situations. One is I start with an initial charge already present on the capacitor and then ask what happens if I introduce a dielectric into it, into this gap. That's the first question. Lakshman, can you repeat my question?
In the gap, what if a charge is applied again?
Huh?
If a charge is put into the gap.
The charge is not put into the gap. What, Raghav, can you repeat my question? What is the first question which we are going to try and answer now?
If there is nothing at first, then you put a dielectric in what will happen?
During this time, the capacitor has charge or no charge?
Yes.
So please understand what we are trying to do right now. Right now, listen carefully. The first question is,
what is the direct?
What happens? Yeah, I'm coming to you. When you introduce a dielectric between the plates of a charged capacitor. So dielectric means it's just another name for insulator. That means it doesn't have charges which are free to move around the material. The charges are fixed in place, they cannot move around. It's a neutral material. It consists of neutral atoms, but with one property that if there is a strong electric field, so suppose this is the dielectric material, if there is a strong electric field in this direction, then each of the neutral atoms will get polarized. Now I am talking about electric polarization, not the optical one. So it gets polarized means the charges will get separated out. So each neutral atom consists of a nucleus with electrons orbiting it, right? So in this electric field, electrons will feel a force. Siddharth, electrons will feel a force in the direction of electric field or opposite? Opposite. So they will now start spending more and more time in this region. Are you getting it? So it will be as if whenever you observe, you will find the electron always, almost all the time, to be present in this side, not on this side. So we think that the atom has become polarized, the charge has become separated. So like this, every atom will be polarized, minus plus.
All insulators will be dielectrics.
Yeah, all. Insulators are called as dielectrics. And they all have this phenomenon. So you will have minus plus, minus plus, minus plus, minus plus. Like this everywhere. As a result, what happens? Each of these polarized atoms create their own electric field. With plus on the right hand side, minus on the left hand side. So they will create a mini electric field in this direction. Are you getting it? So what happens to the net electric field? So there was an external electric field of blue E. There is an induced electric field of red E in the opposite direction. So the net electric field will be less. Okay. So in this space between the capacitor plates, so suppose I have already charged it by using a battery. Okay. After charging plus Q, minus Q on the each plate, using a battery, I remove the battery and then I replace it with a voltmeter. Now, can current pass through a voltmeter? No. To show the deflection of needle, obviously a very small current, say milli or micro amperes of current will pass, but that is considered as negligible current. Okay. So, for all practical purpose, current cannot pass through a voltmeter, but it will show us the value of potential difference across the plates. Okay, so whatever charge is already on this plate, you cannot pass through the voltmeter and neutralize this. That is not going to happen. So it has infinite resistance. The voltmeter has infinite resistance. So don't worry that it will go and cancel out the charge. It won't happen. They will remain separated. And it will instead show us the potential difference. So now, initially, we have connected it to a battery of voltage V, and the charge was Q, and the capacitance was C. Agreed? So the charge Q which was stored was equal to CV. This was the initial value. Right? And for this particular voltage which was present initially, okay, we all know that electric field which was present in between the plates. Let us call it E initial. Okay? This electric field is the potential gradient. The distance between the plates, let us call it D. By this action of introducing a dielectric or insulator material, are we changing the D? We are not changing the D. Don't talk about effective distance at all. You are complimenting it. The actual distance between the plates only we are talking about. We didn't do anything to that. So D is fixed. Right? But now the electric field has become different. It has become less. Because of introducing the dielectric and due to the polarization and the induced opposite electric field, the final electric field EF is now less than the initial electric field. But the distance between the plate is same, small d as before. Right? And what is the relation between electric field, distance and potential difference across that distance? What is the relation between these three quantities?
D is equal to E by T.
ED. E equals D by T. So E equals D by D, where B is potential difference across a distance of D. The proper equation is E equals minus of V by D. Because the potential difference will be negative if you travel in the direction of electric field. Okay? But now we are only interested in the magnitude of this relationship. So we will not bother about writing the minus sign. So now, if E is V by D, and if E has decreased, and D is constant, what can you say about V?
It will decrease.
V also has to?
Decrease.
Agreed? This is the logic in IB they test you, in paper 2. They ask this question and they expect you to give the logical explanation, step by step. If it's a 4-mark question, 1 mark for each step in the logic. So you should be able to explain, I will test you after I finish. So now, due to the dielectric, electric field decreased. Since the separation is constant, the potential difference between the plates decreased. But can the charge change? The charge on each plate, can it change? It is trapped. It cannot go out, it cannot move anywhere. So it is trapped. So the charge is same. But voltage, the potential difference between the plates has decreased. So what happens to the capacitance?
Increase.
So how will it increase?
See for yourself. Capacitance is Q by V. How much charge it can store per unit of potential difference between the plates. You are having the same charge as before, but now the potential difference has decreased. So earlier it was storing, let us say, 10 coulombs for a potential difference of 5 volts. But now the potential difference has become 1 volt. So the same 10 coulomb is now stored for a potential difference of just 1 volt. So the capacitance has effectively increased. Clear?
Capacitance is equal to epsilon into A by D. So A here is the same, D is the same.
Good point. Now you are saying capacitance is equal to epsilon A by D. Right? So A and D are fixed. And I said capacitance has increased. Agreed? So how is that possible? So that means epsilon has increased. It's a constant if you don't change the gap between the, if you don't change the space between them. It's a constant of the medium between the plates. epsilon is the absolute permittivity of the medium between the plates. If it is vacuum, it is called as epsilon naught. Okay? If you insert a dielectric, we say that if the dielectric has a dielectric constant epsilon r, relative permittivity of epsilon r. Okay? Whatever dielectric we introduce, say glass, plastic, whatever material you introduce, it will have its own dielectric constant or
which is always
more. Yeah.
It's more than epsilon naught.
Yeah.
So epsilon naught has the least.
So epsilon naught times epsilon r will give you the final permittivity, which is epsilon. Are you getting it? So by adding an epsilon r, it will become the new permittivity will become epsilon.
Epsilon naught is the least permittivity. Epsilon.
Yeah.
So vacuum has the least permittivity.
Yes. Here. Okay. So is this part clear? Would anyone like to explain the logic? Would anyone like to try explaining the logic? Bashman?
So basically what happens is when the
dielectric
is placed in between the two plates which have charge.
Okay.
It gets polarized, the atoms obviously the electron switches to one side and the atoms become polarized.
Okay.
Producing creating a net electric field in opposite direction of the electric field between two plates.
Okay.
That in turn reduces the overall electric field of the two plates.
Okay.
And the distance between the two plates remains the same. Between two plates remains the same. Therefore, the voltage drops because E drops and distance remains the same. So voltage has to drop. And since voltage drops and charge cannot move from these two points, therefore you want to charge. Overall charge remains the same and voltage.
Just rearrange it. So now we want to talk about capacitance.
Capacitance
is Q by V.
Capacitance increases.
Q remains same.
Voltage
and this has increased. So this will increase. Clear? Excellent. Yeah.
So potential difference is created by the difference in charge all the.
See, potential difference depends on the electric field over a certain distance. Potential difference between two points creates electric field.
Yeah.
So if you say that electric field has decreased, conversely potential difference has decreased.
But if the charges are the same, aren't they at the same potential?
But then the field has decreased, right? Due to the introduction of the dielectric. The field has become weaker. See, field determines the potential difference. If the field is very strong, which is represented by very closely packed field lines, what does it mean? The force will also be very strong. Electric force will also be very strong. If I have to bring a unit positive charge from infinity and bring it to this plate, I have to do work against a very strong electric force, so the potential energy will build up. So when I travel opposite to the direction of electric field and move a charge from the lower potential to higher potential, the work done will be very large if the electric field is very high. But if the electric field is low, when I move a charge from the low potential point to the high potential point, it will gain less potential energy. So the potential energy gain is less, means the potential difference will also be less. Clear? So you are right. Seems that it should depend on the charge, but then the field has become different because of the medium change. Clear? Can we move on to the next question? Now the next question is, again I start with a capacitor, but now instead of voltmeter, I have a battery, which provides a constant potential difference between the plates, and now I introduce a dielectric. Then what will happen? So let's, now this one you should try to figure it out on your own. I will check whether you are on the right track. So try, make an attempt. The question is, what happens when you increase the dielectric between the plates of a?
Increase the dielectric.
distance of separation increases.
Capacitor connected.
So
what?
Distance of separation increases.
No, we are not changing the plates. We are not moving the plates. How can distance of separation change? See, the two plates are at the same distance apart. Distance is same, A is same, but now I have a battery which is connected to the two plates. The battery provides a constant potential difference of V volts. See, in the earlier case, potential difference could change, but charge was fixed. But now, potential difference is fixed. So what can change?
Charge.
Charge can change. Okay?
How can charge change?
Battery can supply charge.
You have to move the voltmeter.
Now battery is there, not voltmeter. So the battery can supply charge or remove charge, whatever, depending on the situation. So now when I introduce a dielectric, what will happen? Who wants to try? Only if you try, you will improve in your thinking skills. So I introduce the dielectric. Yeah, just a logic of thought, that's it. Like previous case, same way build up the logic and come to the conclusion. What happens to the capacitance finally? Come on. You want to try? Come on.
What is the question going to be? Capacitance and distance of charge.
Yes. Correct. So, I want you to explain it step by step. Kuna, would you like to try? No. Okay, Tarun.
Capacitance is equal to epsilon into A by D.
Okay.
When you introduce the dielectric, the value of epsilon.
You directly come here. Always going for the shortcut. Okay, explain from polarization phenomenon.
So A by D, not A by A.
Explain from polarization. This is mathematical approach.
So A by D.
Explain how we did earlier. No? When a dielectric is introduced, what happens to the material?
Get polarized.
Get polarized. That is the first step. So dielectric gets polarized. See, this is in the marking scheme. They will give marks like this. When they ask you what happens, and it's a four-mark question. First mark is the first step in the logic. That is, dielectric gets polarized. One mark. Then what happens?
Opposite.
So when it gets polarized, what happens?
So electric field is induced in the direction opposite to the.
Yes. Opposite electric field is induced in dielectric. Because of that, what happens?
Because of that, the electric field outside.
So net electric field
decreases.
Agree? Yeah. Because of that, what happens? If the net electric field between the plates decreases, what happens? Continue.
V is same.
V is not same instantly. It will take time to become same again. The moment we introduce the dielectric, electric field becomes weak. The potential difference between the plates becomes less than the potential difference of the battery.
Okay, so charge will travel.
So current will flow. The moment there is potential difference, current will flow. Initially, when the capacitor was fully charged, the potential difference between the plates was also V. And the cell was also V. So there was no current from here to here. But now, due to the electric field became weak. So the potential difference, this V became less, but this is more. So now, current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. So charge will accumulate, positive charge will come here, negative charge will come here, till both the potential difference become equal. Are you getting it? So initially, so net electric field decreases. So V across capacitor plate decreases. This causes. Okay.
Okay, let's say charge moves into the plates. Charge moves into capacitor plates from cells. It means Q increases. Agreed? Now Q increases and V is remaining same. Yeah, continue. Capacitance equals Q by V. The potential difference across the capacitor plate is remaining same or different?
Same.
It initially decreased, but immediately charge entered the plates and made it again equal to the old value. So V is same. But Q has become more.
It always becomes equal to the potential difference of the source.
Yes. Yes. So capacitance increases. Understood the logic? So anything in physics can be built into a logic chart like this, from cause to effect. So always practice drawing logic charts like this to test your conceptual understanding. And it's easy for revision also, right? You can just quickly have a glance at this logic chart and you are done. Clear? Okay, now next thing is capacitors in parallel and series. We try to derive the effective capacitance when you connect capacitors in parallel and series. You have done effective resistance when you connect resistors in parallel and series, right? Similar to that. But here, it stores charge. So for example, suppose somebody has a heart attack and the heart has stopped beating. So the muscles, actually, do you know how the heart is able to keep beating all the time? How the muscles are able to twitch into contraction, relax, contraction, relax? How does a muscle know when to contract? What makes it contract? Any idea?
Signals from the brain.
Signals are in what form?
Electric
voltages. So the brain sends an electric signal, a potential difference is sent across the neurons, nerves. And that triggers, that jolt of voltage triggers the muscle to twitch and beat. So the heart gets this signal at a constant rate, so that it beats at a particular rate, periodic rhythm. So if the heart suddenly stops, and if you want to make it start beating, you can give it a quick burst of charge, or a shock, or a voltage. So for that, they use a capacitor. So it will store a lot of charge in it, and it will discharge the charge in one, in say millisecond or picosecond or whatever. So it's like a high voltage is produced for a very fraction of a small fraction of a second. Because so much of charge travels in so little time. Okay. This is one application. And the other application I hinted when I talked about full wave rectifier. If you just use four diodes, the DC voltage, the DC current which you get will be like this, bumpy. If you use a capacitor, it will become like this. You will understand after which move. This we'll come back to this news. It is the last topic in this chapter. You need to understand how and what rate the capacitor stores charge, that is, gets charged up, and when you discharge it, at what rate it will discharge. So you will find that it will discharge slowly. So you use a capacitor, so it will take some time to charge. And before it can discharge during the negative cycle, it will complete.
So then it will charge again.
So before it can discharge, the next positive cycle will start charging. So the voltage across the capacitor will be taken as output. You got some idea, I think. We will come back to it in detail. Now let's derive the formula for capacitors in parallel. Can you try on your own? You don't have to wait for me to teach.
1 by C, 1 by C.
No, that was for resistors in parallel. It's exact reverse. Effective capacitance formula is the reverse of effective resistance formula for series and parallel. So remember it like that. So effective capacitance in parallel is same as effective resistance in series. Just the sum of capacitance. Can you now derive it? Please try. Don't wait for me. Yes.
So let's draw two capacitors. Parallel. Fine. When I say two capacitors are in parallel, what I mean is their corresponding plates are joined together and they are connected to the same potential. So these two corresponding plates are joined together and connected to the low potential. These two plates are joined together and connected to the high potential. So now just see carefully. It is as if the two plates are joined together to form a bigger plate. Don't you think so? So whatever charge this positive plate wants to dump, it now has twice the area to dump if they are identical capacitors. Similarly on this side, right? So let's do. So let us say this capacitor has a capacitance of C1, this one has C2, and let us say the potential difference of the battery is V.
Won't it be same with the identical capacitors?
Okay, so let's not take them to be identical. They are different, so they have different areas. So what I meant was, the area will be the sum of the two areas of these plates. Area of this plate plus area of this plate is now available to store the charge when they are in parallel. Clear? So now what can infer? V is same. So the charge would be Q1 would be C1V. The charge on this plate would be Q2 will be C2V. So let us say we replace it with an effective capacitor. So this whole thing is removed and you replace it with a single capacitor which has a capacitance of C effective. Okay? So what will be the potential difference across it?
V.
V only. So the capacitor potential difference across the effective single capacitor will also be V. So let us say the charge which is finally stored on that is Q. So that Q will be equal to
C
effective into V. Agreed? But we know that the total charge has to be the sum of these two charges. Agreed? Sum will be the same thing. So Q will be equal to Q1 plus Q2. So you get C effective into V equals C1V plus C2V. So the V cancels out and you get C effective equals C1 plus C2. So you can extend it to any number of capacitors in parallel. Clear? Now can you derive for capacitors in series? Just like we did for resistors in series and parallel, similarly only this goes around. Right? Don't be lazy. Right? One boy trying it. What about the others? No one else is trying it. Right? Put pen on paper. Overcome your inertia. Okay. Are you trying? Right? Yes. Kunal, come. Okay. So now when you have capacitors in series, one interesting thing is the charge, what will be same in both?
It's changing the current.
There is no current in a capacitor. Because current cannot keep flowing, right? There is a gap between the plates. Current cannot flow.
So what will be same?
Initially when you connect it,
so the sum of the
this plate will remove some electrons from this, making it plus Q. Agreed?
immediately it will attract some electrons equivalent to plus Q here, so that it becomes minus Q. It attracted it from this plane. So this plane also becomes plus Q. It will immediately attract the minus Q. That will attract the electrons from the negative plane. Are you getting it?
Yes,
so the electrons effectively move from this plate to this plate, and so the charge which will be on each plate will be equal. When you have capacitors in series, the charge flowing each capacitor has to be equal, because charge cannot accumulate at any single point. Conservation of charge principle, right? Charge cannot accumulate at a single point. So if certain charge is plus Q is removed from here, it has to dump here through the battery. If it dumps here, it will push it away here, so that the charge on each capacitor is same, which is Q. So let us call it Q. Now this is C1, this is C2, and this is V. So the potential difference will be now distributed between them as V1 and V2. So now you will do V1 plus V2, V equals V1 plus V2. So if I replace it with a single capacitor of effective capacitance, C effective, it will be having a potential difference of V. And the charge on that will again be just these two plates, right? The outermost plates. So it will again be Q. So now you can just use Q equals CV and plug it in. So V equals Q by C. So this V is Q by C effective. So Q by C effective equals Q by C1 plus Q by C2. So Q will cancel out and you get 1 by C effective equals 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. The key point here is the charge will be same on all the plates. So when you replace it with a single effective capacitance, again the charge on each plate will be same. It behaves like the outermost plates of this setup. So the voltage is same. Clear? Okay, stop the recording. Be louder.